The Supercross is back. What's not to love? We all love it. If you love it, you love it. And if you love it, you love it. You listen to Pulp MX, you listen to everything. You know, I watch all the podcasts I can. You know, I love Travis Ride. You know, he talks to me now and again online, you know, but nothing like buddies. But, you know, it's nice to have someone on the other side of the pond who's right in touch and knows a lot of info, goes to the meetings. He does love the outdoors, but there you go. Anyway, yeah, 450s, yeah, Eli's looking good, pulling away from Kenny, and the Croc is struggling. I don't know if he's got that kissing disease come back or whatever, but if he's got that bar again, that Epstein bar or something, he just looks so, he just faded. Salt Lake City too. He was so fast through the whoops. As soon as they broke down, I don't know if he got tired or he just couldn't make the speed through the whoops anymore, but even coming through the rhythm section, Eli was faster. He was jumping further. He jumped too far. I slid him one lap, Eli, and landed on the flipping little jump before the turn. Nice ball turns. Like, the track has no elevation of any sort, you know, no big obstacles, but that can change. They could do bringing in some fresh soil, I think, really. I'll see what they do anyway, but I'm just enjoying seeing the bikes again and the riders, you know, I'm lining up. Oh my God, get you thinking, you know, the old days. I am a Kawasaki man, so I was gutted to see him in Cincerillo and go down crunchy shoulders, but he's so quick this year, so quick! Pinnock, he's been like fastest in qualifying in nearly every round, like 9 rounds or something ridiculous. But he falls off, you know, and Mathers did say he wouldn't win a race this year, and I thought, no, he's going to win a race, he won the Monster Energy Cup, it's been 6 months ago, but anyway, he's riding well. I think he'll be back for Sunday, tonight that is. Oh, I'm working too much, lost track of time. Anyway, so I'm going to watch that in a bit, because East Coast is later over here in the UK. But anyway, and I don't have any mates into the Supercross, so it's a bit of a devo, really, you know. It's good, because I love the sport. My dad, you know, he raced motocross, but it was, you know, the sort of not early days, but, you know, it was, it's changed. Sport has changed. Last thing in a Cooper Webb, you know, I thought he rode really well, solid, fast, jumped the whoops, seemed to be quicker, if no slower than Eli anyway. As soon as Eli made that mistake, he gave up, you know, it was Coops all the way. That boy's got grit, you know, and he loves God too. I think they all love God. I think I love God. Anyway, I love God now. Bikes are back, now Supercross is back, motocross proper. Supercross. I love the outdoors though. Whoa. More? It'd be nice if some of the other riders rode. Anyway, most of them do. Yeah. And, come on. I don't want to see Plessinger pick up. But anyway, the other good thing that I thought was, like I say, Cooper Webb. He must be number one out of KTM. I mean, is Marvin coming back? Ooh, knee operation. Tries to let it heal naturally, doesn't work, has the operation. Got a lovely Matilda to look after his needs for the rest of his life. You know, does he need to come back? But, you know, Pierce Brown, ooh, on that trolley design, KTM. He's got talent, that boy. He just needs to, you know, stay on 2 wheels, but that'll come. I always take a faster rider or a rider who's fitter. So, yeah, Pierce Brown, it's a pity the French lad couldn't be there, but it's just one terrible things. Impressed with Dean Wilson as well. I love Dean Wilson. He's from Scotland, you know, he's a Celt like me. So, well, I'm Welsh, but English, but there you go. Anyway, so, yeah, brilliant. And brilliant to Coops, number one KTM rider. He's still got a lot of points to make up, but not impossible, you know. The mistakes you've seen Tomac make before, you could easily lose two rounds or not, you know, get a bad start and just not cut through the pack for some reason. But I just think he's loving this altitude and being so fit and just used to it. And he's an animal, you know. but I can see him, you know, washing the front end out. He pushes that front end so hard. But, you know, that right hander after the straight, coming back up the straight, looked pretty straightforward, but people were falling like flies there, you know, it was greasy. And even it, well, that was banked as well. But anyway, next I'll be back tomorrow with more Supercross talk. And I'll be able to talk about last night's rates. And, we'll see what happened. All right, boys and girls, love you all. From Wales, Andy, out.